It's your boy Nguyen in the house, back with another bang on video. Well, yes, ladies and gentlemen, we've got wonderful news for you guys. A lot has been said about this guy, Hossein Awa here. But more importantly, how exactly are Arsenal going to pounce on him? Are Arsenal even pouncing on him? What is the situation at Lyon right now? Are Lyon actually signing his replacement? Everything will be discussed in this video, so stay tuned. And don't forget to join in on the live, because on the live, we are definitely going to discuss more of transfer strategies and more importantly, the players that are linked more often with Arsenal. So stay tuned. And if you seek this kind of content every single day, twice, yes, we got live as well. And more importantly, we are changing a lot of segments on our channel. So please stay tuned for a wonderful segments that we've got. So make sure you subscribe and hit that bell icon and make sure you'll be a part of it by subscribing it as well. So let's do it. The first news that we've got is Lyon president Olas, Jean-Michel Olas, has said that Lyon won't lose Dembele, Aouar and Depay together, and adds if one or two leave, they will be replaced. Yes, and looks like they're replacing somebody. Yes, they are in talks with Milan for Lucas Paqueta. Yes, Lyon are continuing negotiations with Milan for Lucas Paqueta, and a like-to-like replacement for Lucas Paqueta is none other than Hossein Awa. Yes, they're replacing Hossein Awa, but let's talk about something else. Let's talk about a source from Lucas Torreira's camp has assured a separate source which has provided us this news that the player has completed his agreement with Atletico Madrid on personal terms. So personal terms have already been agreed upon. Lucas Torreira, ladies and gentlemen, is a part of he would be soon a part of Atletico Madrid because personal terms have been agreed, and it comes from a source which is closer to the player. And talking about more stuff, Lyon president, but first let's talk about Aubameyang. He says, I was thinking about leaving, to tell you the truth, because I had good opportunities as well. But this feeling to be here, the love from the fans and all the club, I'm not sure that by leaving I will receive the same love. That's why I am staying. Two things persuaded me to stay. The first thing was Mikel Arteta, because since he came in, he brings a lot of positivity and a new philosophy for us. I think that was important because it matched my game and I feel that I can improve with him. And let's talk about different stuff. Well, Lyon president GM Jean-Michel Aulas has already opened up about Hossein Awa. He said, financially, Arsenal are like everyone else in a tricky spot. And Hossein could say to himself that the best thing would be to stay with us. Well, that's his choice, so let's see how things will turn out, because Aubameyang went on saying that I think this was the key factor, and as well the love that I received from the fans and the whole club. Everyone is treating me very, very good, so I feel at home, and that's why I am staying. So we all fans, all the board, the manager, every single one of them treated Aubameyang in the best possible way, and that is why he has chosen us over Inter Milan and Barcelona. That were the two main clubs that were linked in signing Pierre-Emerick Aubameyang from Arsenal. But let's talk about it. Well, yes, it's firing it up. Well, the news are really firing up because the negotiations between Milan and Lyon are well underway for Paqueta. The Rossoneri are awaiting the official offer from Lyon, which should arrive in the next few hours. The Brazilian will only be sold permanently. So Lucas Paqueta would be sold permanently if Lyon want him to actually join them. Want him to come to Lyon, and more importantly, it looks like AC Milan are waiting a very quick bid for Lucas Paqueta, a permanent deal for that matter. But talking about permanent deals, here's a guy who left Arsenal and is actually praising Arsenal since he left. Well, Laurent Koscielny has opened up about his 9 years with Arsenal. He said, I had 9 incredible years there. Lots of memories with this club. I know that my announcement video at Bordeaux caused a bit of a stir. I want to apologize to the fans for that. I didn't expect it to affect them in the way that it did. Too late, Laurent. I think you've done what you wanted. You've actually killed the buzz. You've already killed all the respect. I still do respect you for what you've done for Arsenal, but more importantly, you could have left the club in a much, much better way, my friend. But more importantly, I think Arsenal fans will never forget the way you left, and especially what you're unveiling, that removal of the jersey and putting on the floor. Wow. I remember it. I made a roast of the week on that, and I literally tore into that whole scenario. But moving on, well, Lyon miss out on Champions League and Europa League as well, as Ligue 1 had been cancelled early last season, had a very big impact on their financial situation. They are now close to signing Brazilian playmaker Lucas Paqueta from AC Milan. This could only mean one thing. Hossam Awar is out. Hossam Awar is out. Hossam Awar is definitely on the move. And talking about different stuff, let's talk about moving on. Let's talk about Thomas Partey. Yes. Well, Matteo Moreto has tweeted out, well, it has been guaranteed that Thomas Partey is going to stay. The Rojiblanco club is convinced of that, even if it has a clause of 50 million. Lucas Torreira comes only if Hector Herrera leaves. More on it. Keep watching the video. Also, Atletico Madrid are, according to Fabrizio Romano, Atletico Madrid are not going to negotiate with Arsenal for Thomas Partey. They're still convinced he's going to stay this season. Torreira deal has not been 100% agreed yet because Arsenal want a permanent deal. Atleti offered loan and need to sell Hector Herrera. And according to Mundo Deportivo, Arsenal don't want Torreira to join Atletico and prefer him to join Torino instead. Well, Arsenal are angry with Atletico for their inflexible attitude in their negotiations for Thomas Partey. But talking about more stuff, another source said that Torreira is the culprit, the one who has demanded and begged Arsenal to allow him to go to Atletico Madrid. It is the player who has rejected all offers from Italy because he wants to go to Atletico Madrid. He has even talked to Simeone and told him that he wants to play with him. So yes, it looks like Torreira wants to be a part of Atletico Madrid, and that is why he's blocking every other move towards Torino as well, because Torino's proposal for Torreira is close to 24 million euros, and Italian sources have reported, and Arsenal want to use that guaranteed fee to help any Thomas Partey release clause, but let's see. And also, West Ham Central has opened up about Sokratis. Yes, it looks like that West Ham have made an offer for Sokratis. Yes, apparently West Ham have made an offer for Sokratis. Let's see. Let's see you get Sokratis for now. But moving on, well, there's another another one tweeted out. The soap opera Torreira is destined to continue. No agreement between Atletico and Arsenal. No opening to the loan. The Gunners for now are aiming at the sale by way of straight up cash permanent, and are also dealing with Torino, willing to borrow with obligation to buy, but offer plus high is needed, more money towards Torino if they can actually pay up front. Because Fabrizio replied to a comment that there was a comment who asked him on Twitter, please could we have an Arsenal update regarding Awar and Partey. Fabrizio said Atletico are convinced that Thomas is not going anywhere. Let's see what will happen for Awar. Well, talking about some serious stuff, moving on, Jurgen Klopp says, speaking post after the win for against Lincoln City, well, first of all, Arsenal will be playing in the next round of Carabao Cup against Liverpool as they thrash Lincoln City 7-2. Yes, Jurgen Klopp said after the game, thank God we have two home games. Sorry, Mikkel, you have to come to Liverpool twice. It's not so bad. I saw the Arsenal game against Leicester. They have a proper lineup. They want to win the competition. So it is pretty much clear that Jurgen Klopp understands the danger called as Arsenal under Mikel Arteta. But talking about more stuff, well, here's Hector Bellerin has spoken about Kieran Tierney. He says, he made me push myself even further because he was hitting more speed than me. I was thinking, no, this can't happen. I need to run quicker than him. Then he would run quicker. So yes, players are pushing themselves up above the pitch, and let's see how things will turn out. Because Transfer Charger pulled up a news that Atletico Madrid are confident in on a loan deal for Torreira, which would allow Arsenal to sign Partey. I don't know how much truth is there in that. But Arsenal legend posts a shocking comment. Ray Parlour thinks Dele Alli would be a perfect fit for Arsenal. He said, Dele Alli would certainly be a good fit for Arsenal. I'm trying to think, how much he's worth. I would say £50 million. Arsenal lack goals from centre mid, and Alli would tick that box. So it was a suggestion from Ray Parlour that Arsenal should sign Dele Alli to score those kind of goals that they're missing since Aaron Ramsey left. But talking about more stuff, well, Ian Wright has opened up about Donny van de Beek, that he would have been a better suitable player for Arsenal rather than Manchester United. He said, Donny van de Beek, he's someone that I wish someone more like Arsenal could have taken. When you look at Pogba, what he's doing, and you look at Bruno Fernandes, that is Donny van de Beek's position. So people are thinking they're going to see van de Beek sitting with Pogba and Fernandes, but I don't think that's going to happen, because as much as he can play there, that's not his preferred position to play. So again, spend the money. Yeah, he's a great player, and yes, take him, but you've still got to look for the players that you know are going to improve your team. Well, yes, totally agree with him. But moving on, let's talk about concrete stuff, because Sheffield United are reportedly still locked in talks for a move for Fowler and Balogun. Yorkshire Live believe that there's a deal to be done for the 19-year-old striker, and Chris Wilder is keen to complete the deal and will continue to put pressure on the board. Arsenal are prepared to listen to offers, but are in no rush to sell the striker this summer. So these were the news of the day. I hope you enjoyed whatever came your way. All the views and news and everything about Arsenal comes to this platform every single day twice. So what you gotta do is subscribe and hit that bell icon, because when you do that, you get two videos about Arsenal every single day. Make sure you subscribe and be a part of this community every single day. And join in on the live. Today's fun because we're gonna talk about the swap deal, or probably potential Lacazette sale for funding of Hossam Awar. Is it possible? Is it really happening? Do tune into and make sure you make your presence felt by following all the guidances and actually joining us in the live and making your comments. I will see you in my next video. Until then, cheers. Don't forget, we are on a mission of reaching a new target of 13,000 subscribers. Not far off if you guys listen and if you guys actually be a part of it. Subscribe and consider hitting that bell icon as well.